Hello guys, how you going? This is Campbell from Autodidactic channel, and as always, you want to be autodidactic guys, because you do not want to be learning what the mainstream are trying to teach you. Alrighty, so here we are. This is Malta, and I just wanted to show you this, where it is. This is obviously Google Earth. Now this is Africa, Italy, Sicily, and there is Malta. And as you can see, it seems to be the high point on this big piece of land. It looks like Africa was connected all the way up to Europe, up through here. And even you can see the Greek Isles and all this. So Malta's this little, looks like an outcropping on the top of a landmass that was probably above water in the not too distant past. So I just wanted to show you where it is, and yeah, I'll show you a few bits and pieces about Malta, so stick around. Alright, welcome back guys. So this is visitmalta.com. It's just a brief history about Malta, and it just basically explains how it's been just taken over again and again by basically by military forces, just because of where it is, its position. So it just says the Maltese islands went through a golden Neolithic period, the remains of which include the mysterious temples dedicated to the goddess of fertility. So there's a lot of ancient structures all over Malta, which you've probably heard about. Later on, the Phoenicians, the Carthaginians, and the Romans and Byzantines all left their traces on the islands. In 60 AD, St. Paul was shipwrecked on the island while on his way to Rome and brought Christianity to Malta. Then the Arabs conquered in 1870. They left an important mark on the language. Until 1530, Malta was an extension of Sicily and was governed by the Normans and the Aragonese and other conquerors who ruled over Sicily. And then Sovereign Military Order of St. John of Jerusalem took over rule from 1530 to 1398. And that's really where we're told the Maltese cross comes into it. Then following the Great Siege of 1566, the Knights took Malta, there you go, through a new golden age, making it a key player in the cultural scene of 17th and 18th century Europe. Blah, blah, blah. Napoleon invaded, conquered it in 1798, but only held it for 2 years, and the British took it over, and they held it until 1964. They ruled it until Malta became independent. And then it became a republic in 1974. So it's just a quick, just so you know, Malta, because of where it is, it's between Africa and Europe. People were using it as a military outpost. This is the history we're told for the last, you know, sort of 1,000 years or so, they're saying here, definitely at least the last 500. So it is a very interesting place. And like I said, it's got some interesting buildings. A lot of them are quite ancient. Okay, so here's one of those buildings. It looks a bit ancient, and as you can see, it looks like the remnants of a star fort. You can see all the walls. It's, you know, the original walls there are built in, and it's obviously it's right on the water's edge. And as you can see in this photo, let's blow it up a little bit. Whoops. You can see like there's a bit here that's jutting out of the rocks that looks, you know, that's man-made. And there's obviously all this bit here. So it looks like there was more to this, but, you know, there we've got, you know, the nice angle that we see in the star forts around here as well. This is St. Elmo Fort in Malta, by the way. And you can see that these look like newer buildings that have been built later, but this is the sort of original walls around there and out here. So it was... yeah, some kind of star fort, and because of where Malta is, it would have been on the top of a hill. Basically, there's a nice photo where you can see the star shape of it. But like I said, that's the internal, and then it seems to have an external wall around that was even bigger. Sorry, that's my phone. And this is another shot of it, and this is the original wall. So we don't really know how big this was. You can see things have been built in later. But yeah, this is it, and it's right on the water. So there's a star fort in Malta for you. And this is just to show you, like, that's a massive cruise ship. So it's showing you how deep this, drops away. Basically a cliff, and it's built right on the water. And we see this in so many places where buildings, ancient buildings, are big, big solid rock buildings, stone buildings. They're built right on the water's edge, and often on, sort of cliffs where the water goes down quite steeply, which is interesting. This is just a shot. This is in the Roman Domus Museum. Domus just means a place of Roman antiquity. But as you can see, it's covered in swastikas. Here, here, here. They're all swastikas in the design. And of course, swastika is a symbol that is, at least, it's pre-flood, so it's at least 12,000 years old. Comes mainly from the Vedic scriptures, and it was a symbol for peace and goodwill and luck. Obviously got changed. Now this is St. Paul's Cathedral. Just to show you some of the architecture you've got, this is what we see all over the place. So we've got the round windows, the port windows, but these nice rounded roofs, and obviously covered in art, gilded. We've got the columns, the arches, everything there. St. Paul's Cathedral again, and a big dome on top. So very, very nice building. This is what it looks like from the outside. This is the big dome. This is part of it. It looks like there should have been more than one steeple. It's sort of standing by itself there a bit, but that's part of it. And then if we go to the other side, it looks like this. That's that steeple at the back. Now this, obviously, Malta is very close to Italy, so but that's definitely that, what we told the Greco-Roman style. That's just like, that's just classic all over the place, those buildings. Oh, that's just a smaller shot of those swastikas. I just thought this was a nice, interesting shot. It looks like we've got ancient walls here coming in. I'm not sure if this has been built out. It's a bit of a weird angle, but it definitely looks like it's been resurfaced or built later. But it's just got, the symmetry, the arches, the columns, the keystone kind of layout. It's just, that's classic old world architecture. And it's even got, the massive doors that look like they've been filled in and made smaller. Interesting. So I'm not sure even what these are. I mean, it could be just be a facade, but it looks like there would have probably been statues or something in there. But it's just a nice, it's the stuff we see everywhere, but then of course they put their symbols on the top of it and everything, and they brand it their own. So I'm not sure what the age of that is. That shot was from 1900. Now these are called the Baluta buildings, and you can look at the symmetry of this. These, we're told, were built as apartments, and I mean, look at that architecture. That's just amazing, and it's so, what we see everywhere. But as you can see, it looks like it's built on top of this platform that sort of goes into the ground at an angle. I've got like two stories down here, and then up here. I mean, you can't see it all, but it's not two stories. So I've got a better shot. So here it is, this sort of big platform, and like I said, it's a lot smaller here than it is up here. And this is this massive building. What's it called? The something apartments. Just another shot here, and this is how close, of course, it is to the water. And this is an older shot of it. This is that church that we looked at before. Is that so? No, that's a different church, sorry. But these are the buildings now. This as well, there's not a lot of information. There's lots of quarries on Malta, but as far as the time frame of getting this built, again, they say it was built in a year. So here we are on Wikipedia. So this is what the mainstream story is telling us. So these are the Baluta buildings, these buildings here, blah, blah, blah. Site, you know, this is a bit of the history, but basically the apartment block was constructed in 1928 for the Marquis John Scicluna, Scicluna, and it was designed by the architect Giuseppe Sarlia. Okay, so it was constructed in 1928 and it was completed in 1928. All right, so 1 year to build this amazing building. So yeah, just 1 year to build that building, and I found this. This says Baluta Buildings is one of the first large apartment blocks in Sliema. Built in the late 1920s, today it is one of the finest Art Nouveau buildings in Malta. Apartments were already in demand back then. The photo shows, so this photo that I'm about to show you, the photo shows Baluta when this block was still going up, with only the lower floors constructed so far. On the left are a row of smaller houses on either side. The church remain relatively intact today. So that's the church that we saw in the other photo. And this is the apartment buildings, the big ones with the arches. This is them being built. But look at this line. Look at that. It's just going straight into the ground. Like, look at the size of this window here. It's small on the top window there. And then it's got a whole extra, like, bigger window down, so below it. So this is, well, I was mentioning that it's built on this platform. You know, this is a photo. Obviously, these aren't finished construction, and this is saying it's in the 1920s. So that looks like it was constructed at that time. But what was it built on top of? Look, you've got this half-sunk building. Like, look at the angle. This goes straight to the ground, and they've built those massive, massive stone. I mean, I'm not sure how big they were. They were like at least 6 stories tall. On top of them, so you can imagine what the foundation, how strong that would have had to been, and they've just, it looks like they've just built on top of it. You know, why would they build this base going to the ground? Like, they've found that base and they've built on top of it. You can see, oops, this looks fairly flat. I mean, it looks like it's a bit of a weird angle. It looks like it's going to the ground the other way almost. If you follow this line, you see you've got sort of these sort of holes or windows, whatever they are, and it sort of disappears. So it's like it's been filled from the edges, and this is like the low point. But still, I'm guessing it's upright. It doesn't even look like it's upright just because of the angles. So I had to show you that photo. So this is, yeah, this is the platform they built it on, and that's your mud flood for this video, guys. Look at that. That's just ridiculous. All right. Now, this is also a part of to relief on the Baluta buildings. So, you know, not only were they huge and built well, but you know, they're covered in all this sort of, you know, stonework and sculpture and reliefs, things like that. But when I saw this, it just reminded me of this. Okay, I don't know. We've got the wings, we've got the head in there, and here we've got the Sumerian flying disc, and then this is the Egyptian flying disc with the wings off it, and then this is the famous watch. Okay, so that's, as you can see, and he's got his pine cone with some flowers there. And then if we go back, we'll see we've got these up here, which look fairly similar to the watch. Don't know, what do you think? But this definitely reminds me of the Sumerian flying disc. So yeah, I found that interesting too. Now, this is underneath that frieze I showed you with the swastikas. This is underneath that. This is called the Domus Aurea Sala Ottagana. So I'm guessing it's an octagon, but this is obviously pretty ancient. It's underground, and there's a few stories mixed with that that I'd like to go into in another video. But that's pretty much it. Just a quick intro to Malta, sort of what's on there. We've got a star fort there, It's got like a history of all the, what's been going on with all the different military rule and everything. And of course, we all have heard of things like the Maltese cross. So I'll get into that in the next video. All right, thanks for watching, guys. Have an amazing day. Please leave me a comment, like, and subscribe. Share this video if you like it, because all the shares and comments and likes do help the algorithm, which means this content will get shown to more people on the YouTube platform. So if you want to get this info out there, give me a like, subscribe, leave me comments, and share away. All right, have an amazing day, guys, and I'll catch you on the next upload. Bye for now.